Bless up, bless up. We're live here on Instagram. It's Insta Live. It's Melody Mondays with Ross Ijun. Wow, everybody. Bless up, bless up, bless up. You know what day it is. You know what time it is. It's Melody Mondays on therootsreggaehub.com. Yes, it is. I hope everyone's feeling good tonight. I hope everyone is having a good start to your week. It's Monday, so, you know, things are back and things are rolling. It's a brand new week. We're almost done October. October's almost over, guys. What? Time is going by fast. If you're joining us on the radio, you can head on over to Instagram at instagram.com/rootsreggaehub. And you can watch the video portion of this interview. How's everybody feeling? Let me know in the chat. Let me know how you're feeling, where you're located. I'm excited tonight to talk to Ross Ijun. That was one of his tracks I was playing called Peanut Vendor. Peanut Vendor is a bad, bad track, wicked track still. He has a lot of interesting music, good music, reggae and dance hall, to say the least. And I made a curated playlist. So I will be playing all of Ross Ijun music following the show for everybody who's tuned in on the radio. Everyone here on the gram, you know the rules. I can't play out the songs on full here on Instagram. So I'm excited to do that with my curated playlist immediately following our reasoning. We're gonna get to know the king, get to know what he's all about, what inspires him, his musical mission, and much more tonight. So tell your friends to tell a friend. I'm gonna send out some invites and let people know that we're live. October, today was a beautiful day. You know, October is here. It was freezing last week. Today was like we were back in summertime. So I'm not complaining at all. The weather that we're having, let me know how you guys feel about it here, if you're in the six or wherever you are in the world. Maybe it's hot all the time where you are, and if that's the case, I'm jealous, because yeah, we're heading into winter here in Toronto, Canada. All right, Ivy Vibes, I like to see that. Bless up yourself, Steve. Juliet, you're ready. Yes, bless up yourself, Empress. As we wait for us, Ross Ijun to join us, I'm going to talk a little bit more about his music, some of the new songs that we're going to be talking about tonight. I just actually spoke to him about a half an hour ago, and he was on the road heading home for this interview. I think it was home. Bless up, Jimmy. From Chile. Yes. Big up all my Chileans that are tuned in. If you're on Twitter, you can let me know where you are, but it's much easier to come over and join us on Instagram, because it's a lot easier to talk here on the gram. Hi, bless up, Empress Senorita Lolita in the house. Check her out for some celeb updates as well on her Instagram. Yeah, thank you all for joining me tonight. I feel great. Tonight, and I feel it's almost a year since we started doing these Melody Mondays, so we're coming to a milestone. No, we did hit a year. We hit a year, I think it was 2 weeks ago, we hit a year. So that's exciting. That is super exciting. Yeah, we've been doing these Melody Mondays. First it was Melody Fridays, but Melody Monday sounds so much better, doesn't it? So I ended up switching it to the Monday night just because for scheduling. I mean, more people are home on Monday nights, so it just made more sense. Bless up. Yes, yes, 1 year anniversary, Senorita Lolita. How are you, Mom? Good to see you here joining us. I'm gonna be interviewing Ross Ijun tonight. He is a reggae artist. He does dance hall as well. He's got some new songs, one called Dutty Motion, one called Smoking Loud. For all the herbalists out there, he was also nominated for a Grammy as well. He was nominated for a Grammy. Bless up, Selena. How are you? He was nominated for a Grammy for the Sean Paul album Live and Livin'. If you guys know about that album, it had all collaborations, every track. Sean Paul had collaborated with another artist. So that album ended up getting a Grammy nomination for 2022. And Ross Ija is featured on the song called Bust a Bubble with Sean Paul and I think two other artists on the track. It's a big tune. It's a dancing tune, obviously. I hope you guys are in the mood to dance, because how else are you going to keep yourself warm through the winter months? You got to bubble, you got to dance. You got to keep yourself also fit through the winter too, right? Good to see you, Selena. I did an interview with Selena last week. She's an amazing reggae artist. Check out the Empress at Selena This. For everybody that's tuning in on the Twitter or the radio live, come join us over here on Instagram. I love to see you guys and chat with you guys over here on Instagram. Bless up Christopher in the house. It's funny, I saw a mayor, for a mayor that was being elected out in Milton today, and they're Hammett, so there's Hammett signs all over Milton. That was kind of cool. I was like, oh. I don't know how many of you guys voted today, how many of you guys actually went out and voted, and happy Diwali to everybody celebrating Diwali around the globe. I'm going to play one track for you guys as we wait for Ross Ija to join us, or maybe I should send him an invite, that would be good. I'm going to send him an invite as well and see if he is here on the gram. I can't wait to go to Jamaica. I think he's in Jamaica joining us from Yod. I'm hopefully going to be there very, very, very soon, because it's getting cold here in Canada. We don't want to stay here during the cold. I'm going to pull up on a rhythm anyway that he sent me. This is the Visa track that he's doing right now. If you check out his Instagram at Ross Ija Music, you can hear this instrumental on the gram as well. And so, and some interesting videos for those of you that like bodaciousness, if you know what I mean. Listen to this rhythm, guys. I gotta turn off the mics to play it for you. I'm gonna pull up on the rim real quick. Mm-hmm. He sent me the instrumental, but he didn't send me his track. To dance, right? Not to conquer. Yes, you were here. We were here in Canada. We're in Toronto. Where were you? This is a bad track. This is rhythm right here. The Visa instrumental. Okay, the king is here. He's here. Get this interview started for everybody that's joining us on RootsReggaeHub.com, on the TuneIn app, Google Alexa, wherever you're joining us from. Come over and join us on Instagram. We're live here at Instagram.com/RootsReggaeHub at RootsReggaeHub. So I'm going to send Ross Ija an invite to join me so that we can have a conversation. We can start reasoning about Wagwan with his music and his movements. Here we go. Yeah. I was literally dancing in my studio here before I went live with you guys. It is a sick rhythm. Ross Ija.
Yo, can you hear me? Yes, I can. Can you hear me?
Yes, I can. Bless up yourself. How are you?
Blessed love. Greetings to the world.
Greetings. I'm so happy to reason with you tonight and get to know you. And I like to start at the roots, the foundation. I was telling the people about you, you know, what I know.
That's right.
Yeah, out of my own words and sharing, you know, your music, some of it on the intro
Okay, cool.
and the Visa instrumental. And you know, we're here to talk about your music and movements. And of course, we're live on the radio, richrehab.com, as well as live here on Instagram. So I was encouraging people to come over and join us here as well
Listen,
on the
love.
radio.
If
And
thanks
so I'm so grateful that you
everybody
guys
were
are joining us.
tuning. We're gonna have some fun tonight. Give thanks everybody for tuning. We're gonna have some fun tonight. So just stay tuned. You're gonna get to know a little bit more about Rasta tonight. And just who I am as a person and as an artist. So you get to know the creative side and stuff. So yeah, stay tuned. A vibe tonight.
Yeah, I love that. I love that. Thank you. So tell everyone that might not know you, maybe hasn't heard your music, and for those of you that might be fans, we still want to, you know, dive deep and get to know you, King, tonight. So tell everyone who Ras Ijah is in your own words.
Rastajai, in my own words, is humble, a humble African, as you'd always say, humble youth who just love music, love people, love the fact that people take on to the music and people like what we do. So that are just we, you know, we just that simplicity we use and survive. So simply that. That's the best way to say it.
I love that. Simple man. I'm a simplicity seeker because, you know, those the simple things are in life are where you're truly happy, in my opinion, you know. So when you can find those moments of stillness and moments of happiness. So bless up that. Thank you for sharing that humble description of self. Tell me about your childhood growing up. Tell me about your life. How was that? Your foundation, your family life, where you come from?
All right. Well, born Brian Todd Antonio John Boucher. Was born in Spanish Town. Adopted at 5 months by Bartholomew Brown and Elsie Brown. Grew up in Waterford, product of my community. So you can say I went to Waterford Infant, Waterford Primary, Waterford High. Then from there we transitioned, went to some little evening class, went to college, did some things, get one little accounting degree. So them say by profession we're an accountant. Went about and we went to church. Not trying to skip church because we did the choir in church, we did a cappella group in church. So in all honesty, I'm glad I grew up in the church because that somewhat created a base for who I am today. So you know, did the choir in church, or did choral speaking, did drama, did a whole lot of things in church. So after church, started working while doing accounts. That's when the love for music came about. So that's when we got to express ourselves in the realest form. Because yeah, we are singing at the choir all along, but now you get to sing as an artist for your own and express yourself in that regard. So the first song I wrote was actually a poem. Had an ex-girlfriend who she went on a work program. So me, you know, miss this daughter and write a poem. Now me now I send her the poem. So I put music to the poem because me can sing. So that's how the musical career even started in that regard. So you know, it's just the love for music and being able to write. So we give thanks for those days. We give thanks for the early happenings and the upbringing. We give thanks to Mr. Brown, give thanks to my mother just the same, Angela Boucher. You know, she could have put me in a scandal bag and throw me over a bridge, but she decided that she would have walked through Waterford and decided to ask if anybody wanted a child. So in all honesty, I'm thankful for, you know, thankful for my journey and my story because it never must go the way it go. So in all honesty, I'm thankful, say mama. You know, mama did what she did. So yeah, that was the upbringing.
Wow, thank you for sharing that. That's super deep. And I know a lot of people who are adopted end up trying to search for their birth parents. Did you ever try to do that or
If I ever try to do what, say that again.
to find your parents who gave you up, or do you know them for adoption?
I already know my mother. Me and my mother are best
Oh,
friends.
perfect.
My
Okay.
mother, Yeah, man. All right. So funny enough, let me give you that story though. Let me give you that story though. Okay, you like the story though, so I give you a story. So watch this now. 2010. So my daughter, my youngest is born in 2010, Jazara Boucher. So 2010, my family came in my life. My aunt's name, saw my surname, and saw that the person was born in Spanish. So reached out on Facebook and was like, yo, my name is Brian Boucher. My mom's name is Angela Boucher. I see that, you know, just basic story. My mom reached out, my aunt reached out to me. I was like, yo, we've been searching for you for the longest time. So it so happened that through Facebook, I found my mom, found my aunt, found my brothers and sisters. So my whole connection happened 2010 through Facebook. So we can actually say social media are just there for foolishness. You understand what I mean? I mean, I wanted the story, the success story of Facebook, we can say, hey, you know, it actually did something good other than drown. So,
oh, so, I love that. I love that.
So I'm thankful for that, you know?
Yes, that's such a blessing. Yes, guys, don't use Facebook to Facebook, you know, use it for proper things, reconnecting with loved ones and people that you know.
It makes sense to use it for real connections and not just anything, you know?
Yes, yes. Thank you for sharing that. I love that story. Wow, it's very touching because you've obviously been through trials and tribulations and you were blessed to have a family, to have a mom and dad that's raised you.
No,
and
I know
church experience, early love.
You know, sir, if me say me go through trials and tribulation, I'd be lying because me never have a bad upbringing. Me growing up in a house, me know love. Me know a mother and father, in all honesty. So,
yes.
I have it better than most. So, if you say me go through trials and tribulation, I'd be wicked. I think the best move my mother make because of sugar and water my mother could have feed me for that time. So, yes. Thankful, sir. She make a conscious decision as an 18-year-old who had two children. So, in all honesty, I love my mother dearly for that decision more than anything else because I grew up in a love. I grew up in a, I not grow rich, but I grew rich in a love. You get what I mean? So, I know what it is for our father as an example. Yo. You know what it is for our father as an example, for a male figure in my life as an example. So, my brother's the only child in our house. My brother's the only child, so we can't spoil. So, we can't have trials and tribulation. Me experience life as any other, you know, any other real youth or any other person. Yeah, we have ups and we have downs, but it wasn't rough. I can be honest about me. I know about helper come on me yard for a week and I wash my clothes.
Yes. Good. Oh, what a blessing.
I can't say. I have the roughest experience, in all honesty. You see me? So I have to be honest about it.
Yes. I love that. I love that you had a good experience.
Yes, I me give thanks, man. And then everybody get that. It's not everybody get that, but me give thanks. So for me, just placed me in a situation where it was conducive for my mental and for my upbringing, for my development. So I'm thankful.
Yes, yes. Thank you for sharing that. Tell me more about your music and, you know, what started your inspiration and your love for music started early. So tell me, what are some of the things in your life that you have been inspired by creatively?
Creatively, I'm inspired by life, in all honesty. I'm a person who my friends would classify as an owl, meaning I can sit somewhere and my head will just be like, so this is me. So I'll just be looking at everybody doing what they're doing in their own time, in real time. And that's where the inspiration will come from. I'll see maybe a child do something or even an animal do something and it just inspires something. So my music is inspired by life. If I hear the track, in all honesty, there are times when I write before I hear the rhythm. But then 9 out of 10 times I'm going to hear the rhythm and then something is going to be inspired from the rhythm. So that's mostly how
Oh, I
my
love that.
creativity is sparked.
I love that. I love that you said that because I was definitely going to ask you about your creative process and what comes first, the rhythm or the lyrics. But it sounds like for you, the rhythm comes first.
No, the rhythm, that's all right. I can, like right now, I'm at Big Yard. I'm at Big Yard Studios right now. So I'm here for Sean Paul's rehearsal. So like right now, I can be at the studio and I hear something and you can get a song right now. But then you'll have some days I'll sit home with the track, spend days on the track and just listening to the rhythm, enjoying the rhythm. And even in my sleep, the rhythm is playing. So then I'll just wake up in the morning and that's the song. I'll just go in the studio and that's the song. I don't need to hear the rhythm anymore. I don't need to write because my
Wow.
subconscious already starts writing that song because in my head I'm hearing the words without even saying anything or thinking anything. Because the rhythm is
Nice.
that much, I'm that much in tune with the rhythm. So, the process is different at times, so I'm thankful for that. That's why I'm able to do 9 to 5 because and when I was doing 9 to 5, I knew exactly what the day's process is. With music, it's I like the uncertainty. I like that today brings a different vibe than yesterday. I like that today might be more challenging than yesterday. So I like the difference that it brings. I like the challenges that comes with each and every day. So for that, I'm thankful. So, we just do it accordingly. We apply ourselves accordingly. And that's the best way I know how. So, the
Yes.
process is what it is. Let's say that, let's put it that way.
Yes. It sounds like you have some divine inspiration that, that's something that happens subconsciously almost, like it sounds like very much a gift that you have for creation. So that's interesting how you describe it. I can sort of imagine you birthing these ideas and putting them on the rhythm and it turning out the way it has. I've been listening to a lot of your music. I've curated a personal playlist that I'll be playing for everybody on the radio in full, following our reasoning, because I can't play the music out in full here on Instagram.
I'm
So
on
I specifically chose songs
the
that I found that I love of yours. So there'll be a special Ras Agai music playlist that'll be happening right after the show for everybody so they can really dive deep and get to know your full art form. What's your musical mission? What do you want people to know
I just want to be heard.
or feel?
Like, in all honesty, there was a time. Let's put it this way. Let's put it this way. I'm gonna make this interesting. If you're in a relationship, right? Let's say you're married and you're in a relationship. You're 15 years in. The same mission that you set out, the same love that you started with, is not the same love that you have 15 years in. It's either it has grown or it has withered, right? So it's like the mission that you had initially in the marriage. Growth has determined that you see bigger goals. So what I'm saying, so because of growth initially I had a mindset I know I wanted to be perceived or all of that, but then because of growth, it's now at a place where I just want to be heard. You get what I'm saying? As long as I'm
Yes.
heard, you will see exactly where I'm going. It's either you come on this train or this train will leave. So For me, it's just being heard. So now the mission is to be heard, because from you hear what I have to deliver, what I have to offer, you're going to like it. You're going to be like, yo, where was he? Why is this person not on a bigger platform? Why is he not?
Yes. Video just froze for a second, but definitely want to hear this music, guys. Definitely do. Especially if you're like me and you like to dance and you like to feel something from the music. Ah, we lost Ajay. I thought it was Aja, but it could be Ajay. But my pronunciation is pretty Torontonian. Yes, I'm going to send it back an invite, guys, because I want to get a little deeper. Bless up yourself, Queen Omega. I'm actually having Queen Omega on. Yes, soon, in a couple weeks. Bless up, King.
We see you expire, so we see your title expire.
We want to hear you. We want to hear you.
Yeah, man, we're there, man. We're not leaving, man. We're there, man. We're there. We're not leaving.
All right. Bless. Yes, I love that. I love that your mission is kind of to be heard at this point. And it's never been easier, even though it's still a mission, still got some work to do. But in the end of the day, it's never been easier now to market yourself, to promote yourself, to use social media, you know, to elevate yourself and to reach your fan base and your tribe or whatever you have, not your reggae family, I like to say, worldwide.
That's true.
Yes. Yeah. So I'm so happy you gave the time tonight to let people, you know, hear
more. No, I had to make time. I make time for people who make time for me. So there's no way you could reach out and when I say, oh, and show the real respect and love, because guess what? Humility, remember, you're not born humble. Humility is something that you have to work on every day. So that is something that I'm conscious of. So being cognizant of that, you continuously make sure say, you keep yourself in check. Make sure say, you never get too big for the people and who are never too big for you. So simply that.
I want to talk about your music. I want to talk about your new track.
Let's go. Chubby Dede.
Oh, my God. Okay. So I just been bubbling, to be honest, bubbling in my studio here all day.
Okay.
I'm not gonna lie. You know, I just been feeling to dance, and you know, I checked out some of the videos, compilations, and stuff like that. Tell me about the production team concept. Like, who produced the
all
track?
Right. Dirty Motion was a track that, if I could tell the real story behind Dirty Motion, was done 2020. I did 70 songs in 2020 between April to June. So Dirty Motion was after me recording 70 songs to choose 15 for an album. And that was after that batch of songs. I had more music in my head. Friend of mine, Mixmaster J, sent me the rhythm, did the song. But at the time, I never felt like it was a compilation, but I never felt like my song was ready to go out on the rhythm. Because I felt like it was before its time. Because being a Corona was all there and stuff. I'm like, yo, it don't make sense to do a song of this magnitude and put it out and waste the song. So I never wanted the song to waste, because it was more like this song has more of a street value than just a listening value. So this is more.
Yes, because we couldn't get out, we couldn't get to the dance hall, we couldn't do any of that. And it's a song like that.
For me, I never wanted to put out such a song and not have the audience to match the vibe of what I was saying, and especially the fact that it's really my lifestyle in terms of when we say Dirty Motion, Dirty Rock is Dirty Motion for who know what motion is. So We'll leave it at that. You understand? So we merge. We merge because you hear cartel sing, you hear cartel sing about motion, but cartel sing about motion. You hear cartel say one motion deliver the package, and you hear him say Gaza one motion in the intro. So who know what motion is no? If you know, you know. You understand? So when we say dirty motion, it's dirty rock. And my next little family, when you motion, we just connect together and just know say, hey, well, it's a merging of the family. You understand?
All
So it just
right, big
seems
up
like
the
that.
family. I want to play a
Yes.
little bit of the track. Like I said, I cannot play out the full track here on Instagram because they'll put me in the Instagram jail.
Me coulda tell you about your seat. Motion a run the street. Never have a girl for repeat. We back it no way. Lifestyle in a cheap. Be a dead face in a jeans. Coulda tell you about your seat. Dirty rock a run the street. Never have a girl for repeat. We back it no way. Lifestyle in a cheap. Be a dead face in a jeans. All right. Me touch the road. Me never left a bamba. Dirty motion, yo, that a the gang gang. Girl a cuss off her friend, say she want the top man. After she get touchy, yeah, she get the wrong one. And a trick, she get trick, she a fi go through the rank. Them a fight for the stamp, for rep this a camp. No, we not ramp the crocs in the swamp, and we need this to read. And me coulda tell you about your seat. Motion a running street. Never have a girl, pop repeat, and we back it no way. Lifestyle in a cheap. Be a dead face in a jeans. Coulda tell you about your seat. Dirty rock a run the street. Never have a girl from repeat and we back it no wake. Lifestyle in a cheap. Be a dead face in a. All right, white collar tap a nigga boy. See me them shiver. No one the package you me there fi deliver. Everybody you say killer but a hoe. Do it skiller no one bigger but a hoe. Ah, see them now girl a cheer fi the thing. What we a do fi real them only could a dream. You them lock up in a house when a we a run a scheme. You them know say we dirty but it. We could a tell you about your seat. Reggae up a run the All right, then.
Track is back, guys.
Emotion, you that at the gang gang. Girl, I cuss off her friends, say she want the top man. Man, cause she get touchy, yeah, she get.
I can't play the full track, guys. That's just a little sample, for everybody. And I will play out the full track following our interview. I've curated a specific playlist for everybody that'll be tuned in richreggaehub.com. Well, you can listen on Google Alexa TuneIn app. There's a bunch of ways to listen.
Yeah, man, go stream it. I wrote up the numbers, man. Go check out the video. Make sure you go check out the video on YouTube. The video is out. So if you haven't seen it, go and check out the video, please. And thanks. I want to eat cheese and francs. You understand?
Yes. Go to Ras Agi's YouTube page, and there's a bunch of different videos and tracks that you guys can like and subscribe and share across the social networks. You know how we do it. Tell me about Smoking Loud. I'm a herbalist. All right, not gonna lie, I'm a herbalist. Yeah, ganja baby. So tell me about that track concept production. Are you? I guess you're also a herbalist as well.
But anyway, say no more.
Yeah, pretty much there. Yeah, you think.
All right. Smoking Loud. That track has one of the most unique story. The rhythm, the Blue Skies rhythm, was made in 1983, the same year I was born. So that track was made for Tenasa. Tenasa is on that rhythm as well. It's a compilation that has tenors on it. So, rhythm was made by Papa Michigan, because he's also a producer, big up Rashanko Music. My manager, Brooklyn News, called me one day. Now, me and this man are apart from 2008. Every time me and this brother are apart, me and cook. Just remember that. Every time me and this brother are apart, me and cook. So one day this man called me from my phone, me there my yard, me there water phone in the greater port when he called me. I said, brother, I have a rhythm. Yo, yo, son, I got this rhythm over here. I cook some food, so come over, yo. Because he's an American, so he's like, yo, come over, cook some food. I'm like, yo, what you cook? He was like, yo, I cook some fish, some rice. So you don't need to cook dinner, you can come over. I'm like, all right, cool, I'm coming. So I'm there, I'm listening to the track. When I go to the pot, I'm like, oh shit, the nigga really cook. Cool. I'm there and I'm like, all right. So I'm listening to the track. He's like playing the track. So I'm like, yo, this is wicked. So he's like, yo, I want a weed tune. So I'm like, eh? Weed, son. So he's like, yeah. I don't want a regular weed, so I want something different. I want something like just before I light my split sort of thing. I want something like that. So he's like, what you smoking? So I'm like, yo, I'm smoking low.
Yes.
Because the strain of the weed was low. So he's like, I'm like, yo, I'm smoking low. So he's like, yo, that's the name of the song, Smoking Loud. So I'm like, just before I put the lighter to my spliff, piece of breeze go blow, it's allowed to get a whiff. Must have been an offensive aroma. Gave the impetus to make her come over. Kinda know there was a question when the motion get close. Touch upon my shoulder, say that tickle her nose. And she really gotta know, what is it I'm smoking? I'll say it proud, smoking loud. No afraid for smoking a crowd, I'll say it proud, smoking loud. Me bunny chalice in a crowd, I'll say it proud, smoking loud. So that's how the song came about. I'm like, yo, you're the wickedest. Because he gave that inspiration in terms of like, he didn't want it to be one of them regular vibes. So like the song came about out of the natural element of us just being there vibing. So it wasn't like I said to you earlier, it's not a situation where I can say write a song and put it down. It's inspired by the things we do, the things we say. So
yes, you know? I keep on pulling up on this Protect Me Jah Jah song, but we're not quite there yet.
No, that definitely has a story as well too, so trust
yes,
me.
Yes, we're not quite there yet, but that's another track, a brand new track from Ross Ida. Yeah, I love the Smoking Loud. I do want to play it for everybody again. It's not going to be a full out song I'm going to play. You're going to have to wait till following our reasoning, I will be playing a curated playlist of us, of all of the King's music that you can take in after our reasoning. So it'll be an hour long playlist of curated music, right? But this is Smoking
Which
Loud.
Is right. Which is right.
Sorry, I have it playing for the radio, but I don't have it playing for you guys. Give me one sec. I don't think this is it, but I'm going to play this one for you guys if I can.
People share the live, and make sure I share the live so other people can tune in. Come on, share the live so that we can spread this good word. Remember, man, share the live, share the live, share the live.
Oh, yes. I will be asking questions at the end of the show. Put your questions in the question box down below on the right-hand screen. I'll be taking a few questions, all right?
No, Sing.
Pour up the light and to my split. Peace of breeze don't blow, it's a load she get away. Must have been on a fence for Roman. He gave the impetus to make her come over. Kinda know there was a question when the motion get close. Touch up on my shoulder, say that they could run.
And she really got a nose.
Smoke it loud, say it proud. Smoke it loud. No friend be smoking a crowd. I say it proud. Smoke it loud. Me bun me chalice in a crowd. I say it proud. Smoke it loud. No friend be smoking a crowd. I say it proud. Smoke it loud. Mr. Chalice in a crowd.
Big tune for all the herbalists. I just bought a couple hats with some nice Mary Jane leaves on them. I'm excited about my new hat. With some red, green, and gold marijuana leaves on them, some ganja leaves on them. So, yes, guys, big up all the herbalists. Big up all the people around the world, the healing of the nation. All right.
Tell Which is me. Right.
Yes, it is. It's the healing of a nation. We all, you know, have to hold our meds from time to time. At least most of us, anyway.
Yeah, most of us. It's not that junkie thing around here.
No. This is on a meditation movements sacrament. All right, so tell me about Bust a Bubble. Tell me about what that was like with the Grammy nom and, you know, I think it's Live and Living, and that must have been exciting. How was that for you?
All right, Bossa Bubble for being on Bossa Bubble was for me one of the biggest moments thus far on my career, because you get fed up on a Sean Paul track, you get fed drop a verse on a Sean Paul track. Come on, that's major accomplishment. We don't know about the next person, but we know for me it's not Sean Paul, they for my son. Me get invited for a Sean Paul track. So that is, yeah. One, that is not a normal occurrence. So you understand what me I deal with? It so happened that I haven't been to the studio for like about 5 months. I was called, heard that, some work is here for you to do. You have a song to do. Mm. So what I did, I had a video shoot that day. I was shooting Simple Beats that day. So went to the studio to do my part for Bossa Bubble. At the time, they weren't ready, so I had to go and shoot the video. At about 8 o'clock in the night, came in the studio, just heard the track for the first time, going to the studio, and just laid down the first day. And thus, you see me? When we came out the studio, everybody's face was like, yo, like, what happened? It's like, yo, the verse subconsciously been there, they wait for go up on a champagne track. So me, I did it. So
yes.
We give thanks to the opportunity, we give thanks to the fact that we get a Grammy nomination because we're up on a super, 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 super project. So, you know, we're humbled at every turn and every point of this journey. We're humbled. We give thanks to champagne, decide saying we're going to work with you like me. So, can't complain.
It's an exciting collaboration. The album itself was amazing. I love the fact that, you know, the Grammys, they do recognize and they give everybody involved on the project the nom, and that's and the Grammy itself. That's the way it should be, I believe. And yeah, so we're excited to see what might be coming up for you in future collaborations. Is there anyone else that you're interested in working with? Any artists or producers?
Well, all right, put it this way. We have some things in the pipeline. We have some collaborations to drop. We have Tanya Stevens. We have Left Side. We have an Sean Paul collaboration to drop soon. We have a Beanie Man collaboration as well. So we have a Chi Ching Ching collaboration as well. We have a Soto Bless collaboration in the works. So we have some collabs that are there. We have some upcoming ones we're working on. We have some female artists. We have, mm-hmm. have a surprise one. We're not going to tell you now who yet, but we just can't tell you which part she come from. We have a major artist from over Panama right now that's in studio right now listening to the track. and doing some, you know, just assessing the business part of things. So
okay.
we have some things in the works. We have a remix out with Bojo. That's Bojo, that's the song with Wizkid, with the mood with Wizkid.
Oh, I love that.
So we have a remix out with Bojo and Dave. That's on YouTube. You can go check out that Propeller remix. So that's an Afrobeat vibe. We have our next Afrobeat vibe with Nayara Marley. So we have some things out there where you can go check out and realize that, yo, we've been doing this and we're bad at what we do. We're not just stuck. When you hear what we do, you're going to realize that, yo, the far right, tough it up. Rasta, tough it up.
Yes, so, I'm excited to hear all of those collaborations. You're working hard. You are working so hard. By the sounds of it, you made a lot of music, even over, you know, the thing that happened that I won't mention, because if I mention it, you know, and you took over those 2 years, you've been working on overtime.
We have more than 1,000 songs recorded. It's just to drop music. It's just really fit. Drop music within a timely manner. We have songs recorded and just to drop music. Nice. At times, some songs are before its time. We sit down for some album. So, you know, we're looking forward to enjoying the when the fans get the music, because my thing is enjoying the reaction of the music. Because to know that, all right, I might have leisurely created something that means the world to somebody, now in turn inspires me on a different level. You get what I'm saying? Because sometimes you might be in an idle space and you do something, and then you not knowing that this is not your words. This is the Most High saying to you that, okay, somebody needs to hear this. Mm. It might be easy to you, but this means the world to somebody. So I've learned that don't take the music that we do as simple as, you know, as we put it forward. It means more to people than
we seem to
fathom. So, you know, I'm humbled at all times. Yeah. Every time somebody, you know, checks out and messes with what we do.
I love that you said that, because it's so important that, you know, you're aware as an artist or as a content creator, you know, what you're putting out, and that people are really listening. People are taking it in. People are being influenced by what you say. And, you know, there's a time and place for everything as well, I feel like. And it sounds like you've created so much and you have so much to release. So, yeah, I'm looking forward to all of it. I will be here for it. I'll be playing and supporting the movement on Return Up, of course. Tell me, if you had to choose one, dance hall or reggae, what would you choose?
All right. You know what? When I'm gonna answer that, I'm gonna say if you come down for singer DJ, prefer sing. So let me put it that way. If we come down to sing DJ, I prefer sing.
I love that you said that, though, because it's, you can do both so effortlessly and so flawlessly. So it's like, I figured it'd be a hard choice.
Say that again.
I said you can do both DJ and sing J so effortlessly, so flawlessly.
Funny enough, you know, me just learn for DJ. I'm not gonna lie. May I sing all my life, so I know more about singing than I know about DJing. But then, being around Sean, I was given the opportunity to express myself with DJing, so it grew fast. So came around Sean from 2018, started DJing like today, started in January 2018, and started DJing by the end of the year. I transformed fully to a DJ where we could a DJ and understand the dynamics of DJing. So it's a new formula, it's a new addition to the creativity, to the repertoire as an artist. So we give thanks.
Yes, I'm really excited. I didn't even know it was something like you perfected even more like recently, because it just seems like you've been doing it forever, you know, and it comes across so effortless and just flows.
I wish I was. In all honesty, I wish I was, because there and then I would have figured out the balance a lot earlier.
Yeah.
You know, okay. So that is something that, but then not before time, so I'm still thankful for the fact that, you know, even with a seasoned career, some would want to say, you still can grow, you still can add to that career just the same. So I'm thankful for that nonetheless.
Yes, definitely. I love an evolution. I love a, you know, journey to see what that looks like for you as an artist. It's limitless, really, you know, in a sense, because every day I learn something new. Yeah. Big up everybody coming in here on the chat. I wanted to talk about Protect Me, Jaja, you know, and maybe a little bit about your spiritual journey, maybe something that you've learned in life that maybe changed your, something that happened that changed your perspective on that, on life and liberty.
All right. What was it? In terms of the journey, come with a more talk about the journey before me talk about Protect Me, Jaja. In terms of the spiritual journey, like I said, I started in church. So the foundation is more from a Christian foundation we start from, as most Jamaicans would. But then Rastafari make a calling for my life. Somewhere along the journey, I've always been around Rasta, so it's not new to I, but then it's like, can give a story. Can give a simple of a story to tell yourself.
Just went frozen for a second. There you go. That's okay.
Like I said, funny journeys, a vibe where, but they're on some Rasta. I go to church, I'm there on some Rasta, right? And while going to church, yeah, I give thanks to the church journey, but the love for my experience around far, right? Can the eye them hear me? Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you.
Can the eye them hear me good? And see somebody say,
everybody in the somebody. Chat, let me know if you can hear.
Tell me if you can hear me good. Fling up some flames if you can hear good.
Yeah, like it looks like, you're good, yeah.
Yeah, man, all right, cool. So like I was saying, love what my experience from far, I was just a different energy. As a youth, me say, we take seven, take one banana and share it for 7 months. We say we take one bulla, cut it up for 10 a week, and one banana can share for 10 a week. So everybody get a bite-sized piece and you keep it moving and you show love. So them little energy there work, pull iron eye to far eye. It wasn't a major nothing. It was just a little way far I show it, because I go to church, I know about sharing. Yeah, when you have money, you share. But I know seeing that, you know, seeing a little that just win me over upon a different level. And then the search began. You know, we wanted to know more about His Imperial Majesty. We wanted to learn about, you know, the child or the king child. So that was also something where intrigued me even more than I woke up on a book named Selected Speeches of His Imperial Majesty, where it's another goal that when we get along my journey will just teach me. When I remember a reporter asked His Majesty, what would he tell a young Christian? And His Majesty said to the reporter that he'd tell them to know about the secular and the spiritual, because there in which you find balance, you can live life. So when you simplify it like that to I and I need it no other way but for Chad Farah, just but for Fala Farah, and also His Majesty, and that example by which my example by which I want to follow that person, the more I emulate that person, yeah, more I walk like and talk like, you know. So like how some people want to walk and talk like Jesus. I don't have a problem with that, but I want to walk and talk like His Imperial. My name might be 6'2", my tall, and His Majesty, because His Majesty, I'm a little bit of man. But so we have a step a little bit different. My step them taller, but more step humble like how the king humble. The humility where the king, the title where the king get to be recognized as a docile king. You know, feel like more on a title escape me. You see me dealing, so that is something too where I prefer to use wits. So I always tell people, say, me use passive aggression as opposed to. I prefer to use passive aggression as opposed to brute force. You get what I'm dealing, so like how the king use passive aggression and conquer only someone other. So I just simply that make a choose for her. I don't know, nature nothing. Me no want, me never want to come bush up and nat you. I say me no want to comb me here. Is it make a merit sweet boy like someone? But we just said, is it when you realize that when you realize that looks is not everything, and this is the naturalness, we take on the naturalness. You get the idea, we give thanks. So, you know, like this, a simplicity we use as survive, so it make it even more fun for Baba dead in our show now. Baba go broke.
Not making no money.
Nah, come
Yes, I love that. How long has it been your lock journey? When did you start your lock?
on here. My lock journey start 2017. When my lock start like maybe a giant. Like who know me knows a picky locks did it start 2015 years me ago, you know. So we give that. So I mean, know my locks more blessed than most people. I mean I do me not go hairdresser I go do that something there. So if we did that groom up, then you know so we did a weird amount part. So you know, do that something there.
I like it. True Natty. I like it. Okay, so tell me about Protect Me Jaja production, concept, all
All right,
that.
Protect Me Jaja was produced by Dirty Rock Production. We got the family, we got the boss, we got Sean Paul, anywhere they in the earth. It's a man daily, like, big up Brooklyn News, big up Bama, big up Jason, big up the whole Dirty Rock team. Don't know, we got out a long bit time. Protect Me Jaja was one night, News and I, my manager and I, Brooklyn News was in the studio because he's also a producer. So he's more producer than management, really and truly. But we were in the studio one night and he had the rhythm and the song just, I think something happened. I think I'm trying to remember. I think some vibe happened. I think somebody got shot or something along the lines. And it was just, because me live on a block where it's like how Jane and Finch at. Yeah, me live, I saw the Gaza at. It's where I saw the motion at. So I think somebody got shot tonight. And, you know, it was just a prayer to the Most High, you know, to protect me, Jaja, along the way, because folks out there will have bully. Is it me? And sometimes I want to talk. People could feel up. But then I understand what's going on in your life. So, is it my deal? Like me always say, action there and for talk real cheap. Is it my deal? So, that is something where. So, that is something where. Yes, that is something where enough ones have to over say, here and now. You know, you have to beg the Most High for that. For that covering there. When you step out in the day, before you come out of your yard. Before you go through the door, from you jump up under your bed, from you get to see your eyelid. When you get to see the back of your eyelid, at them time they give thanks. So that man they beg the protection, give thanks to the fox again, so you get to see another day. Because I think that is something where we are left out of the thing. Praises now give again. When I hear a song, we are give praises to the Almighty again. Most I sang now, I goes with them, goes with them. You see me I deal it. So everybody boosted them and hired them, you know. You see me ideally. So right now, I cut and clear. So you see me ideally. So we still a whole hard around you. Hard still a whole around you. So we not stop. We not stop whole hard around you. So when we said to the Most High, I said, if we protect up on the journey. If we cover against them island powder and then rub up your way around. Trust me, some people are rub up on a dry energy and I come around on a dry energy. So we have to black out them sitting there right now. You get me mad because it's like a whole Jamaica rub up.
Oh, gosh, that's a lot. And you went through an experience, and a lot of people go through crazy experiences, especially in certain areas. And it's hard to sometimes, you got to wake up every day and be grateful, because not everyone gets to see tomorrow. You know, every day is a blessing.
That is something me and Jadat, I think a lot of persons seem to not be cognizant of, that the week is a blessing, like the greatest. All right, may I ask you and the people, I'm going to put this to the idea. Out of it, all right, watch this, you know. You can get $10 million, but you have to forfeit your life. I have to wake up broke and keep your life. Which one of the people am I going to prefer? You get what I'm dealing with? Which one of the people am I going to prefer?
Life.
Guarantee yourself. People are going to prefer for broke and have life than if you have $10 million and lose life. You always know what I'm dealing with? So, I'm not asked. I can tell you that everybody I prefer life. So, I put it to you that life is the greatest thing that you can blood pipe and bless with. I understand what I'm dealing. Life are the greatest gifts. So here, I then make a random money. System make a random money. You always know what I'm dealing, but the greatest thing you can be blessed with, my people, is life. Yeah. Sweet deal.
Yes, yeah. I am going to play Protect Me, Jaja. For you.
I know.
For all listeners, for everybody tuned in, I do have a curated playlist. Our reasoning is almost coming to an end now, but I will be playing a full hour of your music, King, for everybody to take in the whole music.
But general, big up yourself, you know. I'm going to say Fraggy Mad Squad. I wish I would say Mad Squad, big up yourself, you know.
Big up. Out-of-body experience.
Protect me, Janja, along the way. He's protecting me, Janja. Cause they don't know the struggles that have come my way. Now you made a way when there seemed to be no way. Blessings come and I see a good healer. In a day, my life, in a day, dealer. She a creeper. Watch out. See ya. Love you, Christian. You claim that you could have never followed them and be grateful to you. You don't even know if it is easy to do. Get part of me, so no one ever fool. Protect me, Georgia. Along the way, this way, self alive, I let the things to stay. If they don't know the struggles, they'd have come away. Now you made a way when they're.
Bless up everybody tuned in on the radio.
Blessings, I'm going to see you get through life.
I'm RootsReggaeHub.com with Ross Ija. Yes, that was Protect Me, Jaja. That's just a little snippet. It's not the full song, guys. I can't play it the full track on Instagram. Like I said, there'll be a...
Yeah, man, go check out the new song. Go check out the Outta Body Experience Rhythm out by Dirty Rock. Make sure you check out the song. Some wicked, 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 wicked song up on the production. Yeah? You get what I mean? The busy signal up on the production. Sean Paul, Soto Bless, Ching Ching and Serrani. You understand what I mean? Dealing. One female artist up on the rhythm. So I'm glad to hear for your song, Laurel 10. Is a man did so go check out the music. Wolipa, 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 good music out. So just check out the compilations, people. Do me a big one. Yeah.
Out of body experience rhythm.
Play Visa rhythm early, you know.
I was playing the Visa rhythm. That rhythm is
wicked. Yeah, you play the Visa rhythm early, you know. I said, wait, that's such a bad God have Visa. Trouble.
That's where that rhythm is sick. Tell me, bless up Whitey Don. I see him in the chat there. It's his birthday. It's Earthstrong. Bless up, King. Tell me about what you're currently listening to.
Like, what is the if you put on your iTunes list or your Spotify,
what playlist
are on your current playlist?
I don't know why you're my playlist. I'm my playlist, boy. I'm not tell you. I don't know why you're my playlist. There you go. All right. Go on a little chubby. See, my playlist now. I'm not listening to reggae. I'm not listening to dance. I'm not listening to genre. I don't listen to the genre that I do. That's a weird thing. Hey, don't listen to the genre that I do. So, I'll more listen. You will hear me, I listen to Baby. You will hear me, I listen Talib Kweli. You will hear me, I listen Kendrick Lamar. You will hear me, I listen Drake. All who know me know say Drake is my artist. Yes. You see me? J. Cole, Fabulous, me I listen to Heavy right now. All them freestyler Fabulous I drop right now. Fire for me. Because I'm a lyric, me like lyrics. So, I like lyricists. As somebody says, souls, yeah, means a souls listener too. Obviously, a person that knows the vibe of the world. So, yeah, means an R&B listener. I listen only for R&B. I listen old school, Otis Redding, Sam Cooke.
I love Otis.
Like, today I was driving, Sade, me, I listen. Today, me, I Sade, me, I listen. So, I'm that type of person who. You get me, I deal with it. All depends on the mood, but then for the most part, me always listen to rhythm. These days, me more listen to rhythm. And then me Afrobeat, me in our Afrobeat segment right now in my life.
Because yeah.
Israel caught me pick up myself of a fusion, dancehall Afrobeat, a reggae Afro album I deal with. So me listen to Afrobeat every right now. So just to make sure I say, you know, just to make sure I say, you know, we fully soak in the essence of Afrobeat, because if we have a mess around the genre or someone, not even a try sound line of Africa, but just doing some good and quality music.
Well, I love the collaborations that are coming out of reggae and dancehall and Afrobeat scenes right now.
You have to make sure you can, you know, you have to pay proper homage to the music, because I've always been a Wizkid fan, so. You don't know, you get the chance to express yourself in that regard. So we give thanks to that. Big up Stone Boy, just the same. You understand? So, yeah.
Looking forward to your track as well. What are, so for you, I think I pretty much played everything, but is there anything else that you might want to share with the audience that you maybe you haven't shared yet? Any new projects coming up other than, I mean, you shared pretty much everything, but and maybe even events that you might be at where they can find you and come out and listen to you live?
Well, right now, like, we can tell people and say, yeah, well, no, we can officially make the announcements. I guess what? Rasta Jai is now open for US bookings.
Yeah.
So, is a man deal with the official.
Canada too?
No, Canada in other words. We work on Canada as we speak. So, also tell us a Canada official. But right now, next month, Sean Paul have the anniversary, the 20th anniversary for the Dirty Rock album. So, New York can look to see Rasta Jai at the building. We shall be in New York next month. So,
well, New York is not far. It's not far from where I am, that's for sure.
The people can look out in New York next month. So, it's a man dealing with them on the ground. So, you know, say, you what? But you can touch out, because it's going to be something epic for first time. In our states, so we make it an event. We make it an event. People them roll out and come all a vibe with it. Come all a vibe with the Dirty Rock experience. It's amazing you can hold Dirty Rock camp in the place. So that are the new thing when we can tell the world and never know. It's
We can let the cat out of the bag.
Yes,
but you'll be in New York. You'll be in the states. You'll be touring.
We start. So we are so open for booking, so the touring start, you know. So
yes.
You get me, I didn't know if you have fax in December and I see me in Jamaica. So we're there, we're going to open the lines of communication, and all many people know. So watch out. All of them look us up there, we're there, we're ready. And we're, you know, we're capable of rocking and shaking any event you put up and say, no matter if you go reggae, the kettle are great, and if you go dance, the kettle are great, just the same. So,
yes.
No matter what you try, you can't live without having nothing, you know.
Bless up yourself. Thank you so much for joining me tonight and taking the time out of your evening.
Come on, we give thanks for the opportunity to come chat. We love chatting. Who know me knows me love chat. So it's a very probably get the opportunity to chat. I got chat and I love sing. So, you know, give thanks. And I must say, you know, do that interview, yeah, I mean, I do it. I say, big up Dean Fraser. Anyway, there in the world, Dean Fraser. Taurus Ryla, big up yourself. Anyway, in the world, because early days of my career, Israeli cotton picker, Chin, Brandon Mackay. And if you big up the people, Father Boom Boom Kush, NSC. And if you big up the people who play integral parts in this journey. Yeah. You get your mad deal with Brooklyn, Bama. These people. So I have to make sure I say I get my team the real credit what they deserve. I say my video personnel on the live. I don't know if I'm still there. Perry, big up yourself. You know, I love every time. I say Perry school there early.
And can you tell everybody like on the radio as well where they can find you? Like, are you on Facebook, Twitter, YouTube? Like, let everyone know.
What do you think of Facebook? Rasa Jai Music, RAS space A to the J to the A to the I. Music, regular spelling, music, M-U-S-I-C. So, you know, say, you get my daily. If you go Instagram, Rasa Jai Music, just the same. You go YouTube, Rasa Jai Music. So, anywhere you go, Rasa, Twitter, the only place that is Rasa Jai alone. But if you go TikTok, Rasa Jai Music, one. So, you get my daily, just check out the way for half. Like I said, my humble, me do great music. One of those need for add me to the playlist and work. Because me have song for no workout, me have song for no joke too. Me have song for no walk too. We have every type of music. You get what I mean? Because that has always been my...
You're very versatile.
I think that's more the aim when I have at this point in time to have music will fit in every mood where you're in. So if you're in a love-making mood, you can draw for a Rasa Jai. If you're in a baby making mood, you can draw for your Rasa Jai too. If you want to express yourself to your girl, it's a man dealing. So I mean that. I want to give music for every situation. If you're down, I suppose you can give something for lift you up. If you want to go hustle, I have something for that too. It's a man dealing. If you want to go chop a line, I have something for that too. If you want to go work 9 to 5, I have something for that too.
You're so, holding up something for that too.
If you want, if a badness, they say they have something for that too. Is it if you're not dealing badness, they have something for that too? Is it? So I just have vibe. We do vibe music, we do real music, because guess what? Every day you get up, you don't feel the same way, you don't process things the same way. So I tend to do it accordingly in terms of the mood that we're in and the vibe where we do music after them. You get me, I did it?
Yes.
So that's simple that. Just like, let me say, who said this? Just like Steve said, we give him the musical message in all form. You know what I did?
Yes.
So just like the other day, I have a reason with Dean Fraser. I said, boy, I'm not getting reggae, no much reggae tracks. And he's like, yo, since you're not getting the reggae, put the reggae argument on the dance already. And I'm like, yo, see, that's why I love him, my boss, because guess what? Only you alone could have put it in that way there, make me see from that perspective there. So I did it. So when we forward, we say we have songs of a father, and I say, yo, these streets so cold, man, me not so, so me keep my load when me touch pon road. To myself, now my zone, yo, my prepper stay alone, not for raise my tone, no emotion, no show. Can't do just some of the people, you know, watch friends stand for, watch just the way life go. Watch your G do your soul, remember karma, I grow, love your digit, them a flow, while me stop, them a grow. Family dog over everything, say we did know, say we have to win. Tell myself something I forgive, no matter what, no giving in. Yo, family dog over everything, say we did know, say we have to win. Tell myself something I forgive, no matter what, no giving in. For all my friends who aren't here today, the memories won't fade away. A couple shots only mask the pain, and every pull bring me to the day. And all the plans still remain the same. For represent, man, I got change again. Zero that I never play again. We are gonna put the haters to shame, car. Family dog over everything. So we did know, so we have to win. Tell myself something I forgive. No matter what, no giving in. Yo, family dog over everything. So we did know, so we have to win. Tell myself something I forgive. You get what I'm dealing. So we sit down on a whole heap of track where we can just, you get what I'm dealing. We can go on the tracks in days, Bridget. I swear to you, we can go on the tracks in days. Just,
my cheeks are hurting. I'm smiling.
Give her thanks. My humble, we give her thanks. Genuinely give her thanks. Give thanks to everybody who tune in and who stay tuned and take a time out of the busy schedule if you listen to it. What I have to say, you know, we're not bigger than this. All the time, tell myself and make sure so I keep myself grounded. So we give thanks to the ones who tune in. Sweet to you.
Thank you joke. For everybody who tuned in tonight on the radio and everybody who's tuning in wherever you are in the world. Globally in 228 countries around the world. I love you all, the reggae family worldwide. And thank you, Ross, because we will be talking again. And please keep sending me all the tracks because I'm definitely playing.
Never gonna stop, man. Never gonna stop. Like Mr. Wally from Manners and thanks to everybody who tuned in. So they shook them. Big up yourself, you know. England check in, me know say the States check in, me know say Florida check in, me know say Jersey check in, me know say Jamaica check in. You get me, idea. You give thanks to everybody with up on the live. Give thanks to everybody who take the time out of the busy schedule. This is Rasta Jai, A to the J to the A to the I. You get me? It's a Jai again. You know, see the Rasta. I've about a dozen girl over Kenka. Baby, why you making up your feet like that? Come on, girl. You know what's a melody like that? Calm down yourself, my girl, my kucha. The Rasta. Show them a play for real, you know, sir. She had tell her friend, say, Rasta Jai, that. See, on a show, I didn't share them. That you know, see, the Rasta. Now, what you catch, you see, the bumper job. You know how much ghost I carry in that. A 13 of them want to sit down in my lap. So, watch it, man. We give thanks. You don't know where come on. So, me, I don't
thanks, everybody. Thank you.
Love and blessings. So, we are the manners to the world. Honors and manners. You
have a good night.
Make sure you check out the music.
All right.
Blessed love.
Shayna McCullough signing out. RootsWagonHemp.com. One love, everybody. Bye.
Rastafari.
Rastafari.